Welcome to yet another cooking session with me, Jikoni Magic, and we are making samaki wa nazi or fish in coconut sauce. So this is our herb and spice mixture. Mix it very well and set one half aside. Now the one that you're remaining with, add some oil and some ukwaju or tamarind paste. If you don't have this paste, go ahead and use freshly squeezed lemon juice. And then to that, go ahead and add ginger, garlic, and some salt to taste. Now, once you're done mixing this up, go ahead and smear it on your fish in the incisions that you've made inside the belly of the fish, the gills everywhere, and then let it sit for around an hour in your fridge. And then after that, bake it for around 20 minutes at 200 degrees centigrade. Now, as that is happening, go ahead and heat up your pan, add some oil and a very large onion, finely diced. Cook it until translucent and then add ginger garlic along with the herb and spice mixture. Now, it's very important to cook this mixture until it's fully cooked. You don't transfer any of the raw taste to your sauce. And then next, come and add your blended mixture of pilipili hohos and tomatoes. Okay, and the camera froze up on me. I didn't realize it, but I added one large bay leaf, three beef cubes, and fish sauce. Okay, so next, you want this sauce to cook down, evaporate, and reduce. That's why I covered with a splatter guard. Otherwise, you can just leave it open. Okay, I just didn't want the sauce to splatter on my cooker. So this is how you want it to look like. And then come with your coconut cream, very thick coconut cream. Okay, make sure that you rinse the container that had the coconut cream. No need to leave all that goodness behind. Okay, let it cook down, reduce just a bit. Give the coconut sauce some chance to cook before adding tamarind paste because you don't want the sauce to split. Next, taste. This is very important because this is going to give you an indication of how much honey you're going to add or any sweetener of your choice. You don't want to end up with a sauce that is too sweet. Okay, then scoop out half of that sauce and set it aside. What you want is to have enough sauce remaining in your pan so that when you come to place your fish, it will lie on it. This serves two purposes. One, the fish, of course, won't burn and it will absorb the flavors from the sauce from the bottom side, okay? Then come with the sauce that you scooped and pour it over the fish. The fish will absorb flavors from the top as well. Now, the reason I do it this way is because, as you noticed, I didn't cook my fish through. So if I try and turn it in between my cooking, it's going to split on me, break up all that. So this takes care of that problem completely. Now cover with a lid that will retain the steam inside and help the flavors to penetrate and the fish to soften further. Now, after about 15 minutes or so, my fish was done. As you can see, the sauce is thick. I'm just basting some more sauce on top. So that's it. That's our fish. So to complete the meal, I had my veggies, some very nice looking cabbages. On the far end, I had ugali that I always like serving at the very last minute because I like it piping hot. And of course, the fish. So until next time, please keep it safe and bye-bye.